Hi, I'm still in the mood a little bit here, and I'm going to talk about the ascension experience versus the out-of-body experience. What are the differences, similarities, and let's break it down and reverse engineer it and see what we come up with. Okay? All right. The ascension experience, in a nutshell, is in a vibrational phenomena. It's supposed to be happening to the entire physical plane of existence. It's supposed to be changing our DNA and vibration of our bodies and vibration of the earth. If we're following, you know, the read and kind of staying up to speed on the ascension thing, we kind of see it going on around us. As things heat up, literally the vibration increases, increases, increases. If you, the theory is that if you go with the flow of this and stay in your heart center, whatever that means, right? No, I know what it means. All love and stuff. Okay, so if we stay all loving and stuff and stay in the positive and not look too much of the how we're getting screwed by the government, I know it's hard. I got videos up the gazoo talking about how the bad government's bad, right? But okay, trying to get some balance here and go into the positive place. So if you go with the flow on the ascension thing, the vibrational phenomena is supposed to go easier on you, and you're supposed to experience your world in a more comfortable way. But for me, the whole ascension thing is there's too much generality in it and not enough specificity. And so I wanted to talk about some more of this, because I haven't, as far as I know, experienced an ascension experience in a plane of existence before. Maybe I had, I just don't remember. But I have had quite a few out-of-body experiences and consciousness shifts into worlds that are very similar to the description of the world this is supposed to be once it moves through its ascension phenomena. You see what I'm saying? So, a similarity. But just for a starting place, technically speaking, people who are teaching the ascension phenomenon and what it is and how it works and all that, they're basically saying that you don't experience death, you won't experience physical death if you make it and you do this right. What you will experience is a vibrational change in your physical body, so your physical body does not die, it lives on forever. You know, if you get it past this one place, I guess, and you can get past the get killed and all the bad stuff that might or might not happen on planet Earth right now, if you can get by on that, then the idea is to live in your physical body in a new heavenly earth plane that's of the same vibration, and it vibrates higher than the physical plane does right now. You've got the lower vibration, and a lot of people that are not like into this are going to go with the lower vibration, stay with the lower vibrational earth, while the rest of us are going to be shifting somehow and end up on this new earth plane, this new earth place that vibrates at a higher plane of existence. But it's not an out-of-body experience from anybody that I've been reading about, sharing about consciousness shifting, sharing about the ascension. Okay, with that said, all I want to say is, geez, I'm reading about that stuff, and it sounds a whole lot like places I've gone. You shift out of body, you go to a new plane of existence. It's a beautiful world, loving people, just like the ascension thing. It looks like Earth, very like Earth. The trees and the flowers and the people and everything's wonderful. And I go, okay, so what part of this is not similar to the ascension thing? Well, the thing is that this place that I'm going, I don't need a physical body to do it. And I don't need to, in the consciousness shifting out of body experience sort of get there thing, I don't have to depend on this physical body to be alive or dead. Okay, it's not about keeping the physical body alive or anything like that. And it's not about vibrating the physical body. It doesn't have anything to do with the DNA vibrational thing or the whole physical plane of existence vibrating and shifting into a higher plane. Where I'm going in my experiences to these higher planes and the greater reality is not the same, or doesn't seem to be the same thing. You see the difference? this ascension experience, and I'm really, what are you talking about, Rich? Hey, I'm trying to talk this out for myself as much as anybody else. You know, I'm not, I like a lot of things people are saying about the ascension thing, but it's not jiving with what I've experienced personally. I'm going, well, is it the same thing, or is it different, and how is it different, and why is it different? And the biggest contention I have with the ascension story is that, to me, personally, people are making too big of a deal out of the physical body thing. Your physical body is going to change, and you're going to go into a new physical earth plane of existence, right? That's good. That's a good story. That's okay. But when you do shift in this way, you have, from what I understand, is the from the other side of the ascension, the end result is that you feel really comfortable in your new environment, and it vibrates at a higher vibration than the physical, the normal physical plane that we have lived in for the last 20, 30, 40, 50 years or whatever. Okay, it's a different place. I'm going, yeah, that makes sense. When I shift to other planes and I visit, I walk, I talk to people, I sit in chairs and I hug people and they talk to me and ask me questions, I ask them questions, and it's all really wonderful, very real. How is that different from the ascension phenomena that we are hearing about? The only difference I see, or the main difference I see, is that how to get there from here. Right now, in a physical body, the ascension story is that we're staying with the physical body that we have right now, and we're changing it, okay? And so it survives and magically changes into and transforms into something higher and better as a vibrational vehicle. Nothing wrong with that story. Sounds good. I like it. But I'm going, well, can't people just die? You know, what about the people that they're not like up to speed, or like, you know, they're having problems here with this plane, and they die? You know, like car wrecks, plane wrecks, you know, just they got caught up in the wars, you know, cataclysmic bad things have happened, and people have already died. What, are they screwed? They don't get the ascension experience? Is that what? Or were they like first wave, they died, and now they're in the new higher plane? I go, well, that's no different from what I've already understood. You know, it's not something new in that way. In that regard, we die here, and we go to another place depending on our belief systems, our emotional, spiritual vibration, and our inclinations, spiritual inclinations. And so we arrive where we arrive. And I'm not seeing the big difference in that regard, except for the part where, Rich, no, this is, you stay alive, you stay in this physical body, and it transforms into a higher body. Okay, so I guess that's how it works. But you don't have to do that. If you're not up to speed on that whole paradigm or that whole philosophy, you don't have to go there. There are other ways to get to a better place than this place. And it really has to do with what you believe and what you want to believe. So I'm just, excuse me, choking on what I'm saying here, obviously. I'm just saying, let's put it all out on the table, talk about it, and ask the hard questions about the ascension thing, and the out-of-body thing, and the consciousness-shifting thing, and the old world, and the new world of, you know, old vibration, new vibration, higher vibration, lower vibration, all that stuff. Is there another earth vibration? It's already there. And can you get there from a consciousness shift out of your physical body now, before this physical body actually manifests into the higher body itself? There's all that to consider. And the other thing to consider is that I see a sense of freedom in consciousness shifting to many planes of existence, reality systems, parallel world, future, past. And is that something that we get as a benefit when we do the ascension experience and go into, we move to this new world, and there's not as many of us there, but it just, there's so many similarities between the ascension and the out-of-body experience or consciousness shift to another plane of existence. And yet there are some very clear differences. So I'm just saying, hey, something to talk about. Yeah. It's like, huh? Somebody that knows more about the ascension experience, you know, I'm open to hear the stories. Of course, I'm not going out and buying books on that stuff. No, my interest is consciousness shifting, getting out of body, so you know, that's what I'm about. But you know, if I come across some interesting information, I can use it and check it out. Maybe share it with you guys. Okay. I'd like to hear from you on this. Talk to you later. Bye-bye.